Welcome back to the Manila Major 2016 China Qualifier Lower Bracket Final CDEC Youth being slapped down by a newbie from the Winners Bracket Final right here into our Lower Bracket match up against EHOME team, who will be making myself very happy and I think a lot of their fans very happy. Finally, they're finding some momentum, some gel, some draw.
Yeah, but they're also going up against CDEC here that they have struggled with in the past, but this the time, if ever, it is the time for EHOME to step up and take them down.
This is the moment. Yeah. This is the day.
And it's not going to be the drow, though, if we look at the past.
The funny thing is, though, with the drow, EHOME didn't pick it up in the first two ever.
Yeah.
They always picked it up in the second phase. So the fact that CDEC Youth are banning it out in the first two, either it's just respect to EHOME, or they think EHOME are going to like almost push it through in the first phase because they do have the they have the second pick, so they can do the couple heroes together.
It's either respect or it's kind of, you know, there's two things. Either you're scared that the that EHOME are gonna pick it in the first two this time, or they may not actually have, you know, studied EHOME close enough to see that, you know, they never really did this.
I highly doubt the second, because if they did that, then
shame on you.
Yes.
Well, not many teams are crazy enough to pull a draw in the first phase, and I don't really think it's viable to do so. It's so easy to draft against. There are a ton of things that can punish it.
I agree.
So I just don't see the reasoning. But let's not focus too much on that single ban. Bounty Hunter getting picked up first here. CDEC Youth. A lot of high-tier heroes available here. There's, of course, the Lion, the Sven, the Alchemist. Good options here.
I'm interested to see if EHOME even try and, run a jungler. Like, when the bounty's on the field, it's always that problem of rotation. A very stable mid. Another thing to also look for, someone which the bounty hunter can't just influence by just slowly rotating in, tapping up a little bit with that orb of venom, which we've seen time and time again. And things like this really work nicely. So, the lamb, we saw just how effective it was in our last series.
Iron Sven.
Yeah.
That's the pick. Come on.
That actually really is. It's the double stun, double control, and
it's the other brother in arms.
Well, I suppose it ticks both my boxes. It's like, as far as the mid goes, it's a hero who's really difficult to kill, and it's not a jungler. It's a good stunning and lockdown support.
Something that I just, you know, I've been going on about some in this patch. Just tanky heroes that are hard to kill are doing so well. It's hard to say anything other than that, and they actually snag up the Racer reaction pick here.
That's
to the Dragon
really
Knight.
Early.
Yeah, CDEC, they're looking crazy as ever. They're picking Racer this fast. And
is there anyone which you could line up against the Razor which would trash him in lane and push the DK into a safe lane? Would you do something like this?
I mean, there are some heroes that can best the Razor in lane, but they turn into too much of a gimmicky pick. You know, you're talking Broodmother or something.
So you're just happy to go for the lane trade-off?
Yeah, I think you do. I mean, you don't have to worry too much as a DK against Racer. Sure, you might not win the lane, but you're not gonna completely lose.
Is it mainly because breathe fire does all your damage for you? Because you still have physical damage, but you got breathe fire.
Exactly. You lower the enemy, at least their base damage. Sadly, you don't lower the stolen damage, so it's not super good against Razor. I'm not trying to argue that the lane is good, but it's better than it used to be. You know, Dragon Knight has gotten a lot of buffs in the recent history.
I saw a lot of nice burst damage from EHOME, and we're still lining up with stuns, which is...
Well, both lineups already can check off that. They can cancel TPs, so...
That is true.
Maybe not setups yet for CDEC, but they do have a bounty hunter early pick, which I respect. I think it's a super strong hero in this patch as well.
This is the game we get what the panel was asking for earlier on, which is like, where is that Timbersaw?
Oh, yeah.
Bring on ice, the Timbersaw for ice.
Yeah, Timbersaw... I was actually the one crying for it as well on the panel, so
yes,
maybe
you were.
I was the one you heard.
That's the reason why I referenced it.
The little Timbersaw buff and the Bloodstone buff together, I think two things. It really makes the hero playable, and if the enemy doesn't have really good lockdown, then yeah, sure. He can work.
Well, they banned the Lone Druid out.
I also think Timbersaw is one of the heroes that makes the biggest use out of Fair Fire in the game, because he often plays on the edge, if you will. And he makes good use of extra HP because he has high armor, so it's worth a lot to him getting that little bit of HP. Because I see some supports having Fair Fire, but they have zero armor, so when they get chased down, they're like, oh, I'm going to pop my Fair Fire, and then they die in one more right click. You know, on Timber, that would be maybe 3 more right clicks for my support.
I also love watching Tibasaurs up against Alliance, which normally won't drop huge magical burst damage, because it gives time for reactive armor to kick up.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, Razor is kind of that. But we're not going to get it this time around.
Not
it's the Darkseer for Ice Ice Ice. The Dragon Knights, like, obviously, this is just really easy to work with. It stops CDC Youth as well running that Darkseer Bounty combo.
Sure.
That we also saw before.
Sure. It's just an annoying thing. Even if you know it's going to happen, you just can't spend too much money on sentries in the early game.
Yep.
So they're getting out of that little nuisance. And also Surge against Racer, I love that part, being able to get out of a static link. Reserve time.
Interesting to see what they try and couple it with. Normally when you have a Darkseer back, like, the Dual Breath is already pretty damn good. With a Lion, he's practically a Ravage when you've got a back like that. Like,
if you time it
is
properly,
so good.
The point when you have Blink on both these heroes, if you get two Blinks and the enemy does not have, like, three BKBs yet, then you can really look to punish teamfights. And speaking of Ravage, Toby.
Tide.
Oh, I love that song. I want to listen to that one again.
Ishraf,
ah. What I'm about, right?
It's a strange ticking noise. Yeah, of course. They just traveled
around. Mirana! Azalor!
Yeah. Everyone is just thinking we're going insane here on the panel.
Well,
which
most people.
Not incorrect, actually.
Most people think I'm drunk all the time, but what they don't realize is I'm just mentally disturbed.
Yeah, that's true for most of us, actually. People were making a thread about how Shiva might be drunk as a skunk, and no, she's, you know, we just get kind of weird.
There's a thing which happens when you, like, you know it, you sit there and stream all day, and you're talking to yourself. Even if you're talking to, like,
a camera,
a camera or maybe someone who's on the other side, you are still sitting in a room for, like, 10 hours in a day talking to yourself.
Well, I believe in this, right? Hear me out, Toby. The more you speak, the higher the chances that you're going to say some really stupid shit. And it's going to happen. That's just the way it goes.
Exhibit me.
Yeah. You are my case in point to this.
I really am.
So is Sony Pixel. It's fine. So I'm really sad I didn't watch your cast together.
It was the most ironically stupid cast ever. Let's put two hype casts together and have a game which has a grand total of 8 kills.
Yep, that was
in the entire game.
They missed on that one, but they did hit with a Slax and LD casting together on Aghanim's Gyrocopter. They were both crying for it all game long, and then it does happen in the end. Remaining. There's been some fun games. Anyway,
they would have been stroking their memes all through that game.
To go back and address this game a little bit more, I think that CDC Youth has a pretty strong teamfight lineup, in fact. Even against EHOME, who drafted very hard around it, hang up the Darkseer, the Earth Spirit. I think with the Tidehunter, Sven, and now Alina, they have good stunts on this team now. Very nice chain stunts as well.
It's not bad. The issue I kind of have is with CEC, like, if the Bounty Hunter gets caught out, like, if you get a gem on EHOME, you see him coming in, the initiation of CDEC is going to be very odd.
Yeah. Yeah,
like, the Razor runs at you, Titan needs a Blink Dagger, but EHOME can also tank through a lot of that.
You could say
Blink Dagger, but you don't want to get that on him early on, and you want to get the armlet.
Exactly. So, since you don't want to get Blink too early on Sven, a lot of it comes down to how farmed is Sven going to get. Because if he doesn't get the proper farm in the game he wants, then you might struggle to actually initiate, as you said. And keep this in mind, Tidehunter and Sven, both of them want those Ancients. So most likely, Sven is not going to be making use of the Ancients too early. And if he does, then Tidehunter is going to have to farm elsewhere. It's going to be an old chicken on this Slark here. Very good against this, a lot of telegraphed stunts that you can really dark pact easily.
It just feels like EHOME's got such an easier to initiate draft. Like, there's more opportunities for these solo picks when the Earth Spirit rotates, there's something to couple it with, like the kick into Pounce, and the follow-up Lion Sun, or even just the Slarken Lion working together, the kick into Dragon Knight burst damage, plus his own follow-up stun allows Earth Spirit to then start the body block. Top lane, you got Earth Spirit Iron Shell on him to couple with the Dark Seer, or even Dragon Knight, when he gets early initiate on item with the Shadow Blade, he's good to work with. There's just all these things that just seem to be out for me, which is just so much better for EHOME, and I just hope that's an initial jitter.
Double TP out here by CDEC. They want to get these wards down nice and early, and they will. So, giving some vision. And look at that old chicken build, by the way, for the mid lane. That's really funny. It's against Eraser. He built this in particular on the Dragon Knight.
I'm gonna do a quick DC reseek because I'm seeing the jump and I'm going to actually wait because it looks like EHOME could be claiming the first blood if Sven gets called out of position here. If this doesn't happen, we'll do our quick DC reseek. Sven sees him and
Amy.
We call him Amy, but we were corrected that his name is actually.
It's Amy and Victoria, Toby. Don't take this away from me.
I really do want to take it away from
you.
Because if I don't take it away from you now, like I'm never gonna like stop doing it.
Well, all right. I will just whisper in your ear when you sleep, and soon you will be casting the way you should.
Amy. All
right.
Okay. I'm gonna do this because we're jumping around.
This is like watching a Europe game. It's really good. I like it.
Yeah, let's hope I get that connection.
Yeah.
Alright, we're looking better.
Yeah?
We're looking better.
Sweet stuff.
Hey, all you gotta do, this is what you should have done, like we should have done in the 2 hour game that we had the other day.
Yeah.
Just DC reti. Sometimes you just get that perfect routing in.
Yeah.
Doesn't make any real sense, but...
Gotta be persistent, is what you're saying?
Just gotta be...
Toby as musical as ever.
Oh, it's just the song, and I'm just like, what kind of lyrics do I come up with that? All the ones that should never be sung on stream.
Right. We trying to keep it PG-13?
Yeah, come on, man. We're streaming to a whole bunch of impressionable minds in Dota, including the people inside Dota TV.
Yeah,
greetings. I'm hoping our audio gets to you from LA here to through the Chinese servers and back to wherever you're watching from around the world.
It's a big important cast, Toby. I think Lumi is watching, actually, so...
Is he?
Yep.
Oh, let's screw it up, then.
Yeah, okay. Sorry, everyone else.
Shout out to not Lumi. Shout out to everyone else that's not Lumi.
On bottom lane, we see Isis gonna be playing the Darkseer here up against Tidehunter. Pretty much a wash lane. I think Tidehunter can deal with the Iron Shells for a while. It becomes harder later on. But that lane shouldn't be too interesting. Mid... Chicken has a very technical lane. Playing as the Dragon Knight is not easy, or Racer is not easy. And he has the Wind Lace to help him out.
He's at least got the Sentry Ward down, so he'll know when Victoria rotates over.
Yeah.
So that's a big upside for him.
And Kira does not have a Sentry of her own, or of his own.
So we can't actually D-Ward.
Yeah, exactly. So it's going to be hard to make any effective ganks toward the mid.
You've got one on the Lina, though. But that's probably so they can try and find that Observer Ward, which looks like it got misplaced. It looks right. It looks like it should be blocking that camp, but was it placed?
Are you sure?
Oh, it was placed after. It was placed after the camp wand.
Yeah.
So yeah, it does block.
Yeah, and it might actually be hard to find that one. Oh, he puts the lane sentry. Not gonna find anything with that.
Oh, double stun coming out right now from Amy with the rotation over. Lannum's dropping down low.
Oh,
the stun, still gonna be enough. Sven will find the first Fenrir, trying to boulder himself as far away as possible. The Lightstriker Rage is gonna hold him there. And now it's old 11 who's in trouble. CDEC.Y,
wow.
This is exactly what you want to have happen starting it off. Teemus landing all the bloody stuns. They couple it perfectly, and a triple kill for the safe lane of CDEC.Y.
Are you kidding me? A 3-0? On the lane?
I am not kidding you at all.
That's then. Two stuns and Lina with all her spells. She managed to use up all her 400 mana there in that fight. And that really put some hurt into EHOME.
We're gonna...
Nothing going on, it's fine.
Well, back into the game.
It's fine. I mean, bottom lane was a wash anyway. Tide is just slowly farming and Darkseer is slightly faster
farming. Why is your smooth and mine is not? We're literally sitting next to each other on the same internet line.
Well, Toby, it's connected to your MMR, I believe.
Ah, that is bold.
No, I talked to Eric Johnson about this. How do you do it, Toby?
All I hear is a level of crap coming out of your mouth right now.
Yeah, you get bad audio on low MMR as well. That's also...
I don't...
You'll see no. It's still a super effective combo to this day. In fact, a lot stronger than it used to be. Oh, courier attempted snipe by Victoria. Nah, he's gonna find it though. Oh, he's gonna bottle crawl on the way back. Maybe he could find it. That slow courier carrying a important bounty.
Going over the trees though. Like Victoria doesn't have enough damage to bring it down with one hit.
Yep.
So yeah, that's not gonna work.
Yeah, he's not in position for that one.
All right. We're probably as smooth as we're gonna get for a while.
Yeah. Probably. And we're trying to do some rotations. I'm looking towards this Earth for EHOME, because that's really who's gonna start the initiations. And he finds an Invis rune and an Arcane rune. Oh, he could really go and gank quite effectively here.
Not a bad combo.
Oh, they actually give the Invis over to Lion. Much better for initiation.
I suppose because Fenrir is already going to get himself in close enough.
Yeah, they want to bring down this Racer on mid. It's a hard hero to kill, though. Hopefully not going to be easy. They have the chain stun, so maybe do it.
I don't think they actually got enough physical damage as well.
If anyone TPs, it's not going to happen. Lina does not have a TP ready, though. And neither does Bounty Hunter. But Racer is playing really careful.
They can't see him. That's the problem. There's no vision here. Like, if they had an Observe Ward on the lane, then maybe they'd have a chance.
Yeah, Inflame is playing very smart. Like, now it's too deep. You can't go under tower this early.
Yeah.
You're gonna die. And he has that plus one armor, dude.
And so they can move down to bottom lane. Ice, as well as XE have been going pretty...
Oh, they got him.
Ah, okay.
Sven, Lina, doing it on their own. Don't even need the Bounty Hunter to bring down the Slark. He didn't actually get off the Dark Pact at all. So, not managed to deal with those stunts.
Radiant's top tower. This just feels a little... Like, CDEC, like, if it wasn't for that triple kill on top lane, I'd be wondering, like, what position we're in right now. But as far as, like, what happens after that winner's bracket final, a triple kill on top lane was exactly what CDEC Youth needed.
It really was. I mean, that puts them right back in their game as well, because you could feel very depressed after a game like that against Newbie. But now, you know, starting off nicely with three kills, they haven't given away anything yet. I think they're pretty confident. The only thing I worry for is this Bounty Hunter level 2 still, you know? He really needs to get this level 4 at least for the high level Shuri toss, it can be effective. He is close to level 3, but... Oh, he's gonna try for the Bounty Steal.
All chicken knows gonna pick it up.
He probably saw the sentries and got a little bit scared.
I think he's still fine with this. Inflame picks up a regeneration rune from Dyer's the top river. Even just chip damage against that raise now does absolutely nothing.
And while I said that Tidehunter should not struggle too much against the Darkseer, he's actually pretty bad on CS right now. 12 CS against Darkseer's 30.
It's because Darkseer started creep skip. Like he went between the tier 1 and tier 2 towers.
He did for a while, yeah.
Yeah.
But even with a Falling Blade as well.
Oh, Inflame. Mid lane, they're gonna get the kick. They have enough damage. The Dragon Tail has already been used. And Inflame, he's not gonna tick down far enough. Remember that regeneration rune that's there. If they can't find this kill, and Old Chicken committing so heavily, but the attack on the Lark Razor around the thumb, look next, and with the Boulder Fall, the Razor will drop. Demon can't punch attack further, and Old Chicken now bottling up.
A really fast Dragon. He flies in with a boot. Windlake.
It was the dragon that did no damage though, he was 168 negative
to the
damage.
Poison. You cannot deny the poison damage. It's really good.
That is true.
And that Aquasive Breath is gonna do it in the end. And he did get just enough mana for a bottle stun. That was really nice.
A happy day for a Dragon Knight and a big kill that was required for EHOME. They were not looking good in this game and they still are not. Like that Sven is 1.4k in front. Dragon Knight.
That is a little bit disturbing, yes. He is looking very farmed. But the thing is, he's not even to be really compared to a Dragon Knight. The Slark. Where's the Slark? He's so far down. He's 2,000 below the Sven. And he's the one who's supposed to carry against.
He's got two deaths in 8 minutes. I don't think we could expect anything else from him. Why I'm still a little bit, like, off about this whole, like, laning phase. It didn't just throw ice to the off lane.
I do like his pick, though, on these raindrops. Actually a very good item against Sven and Lina when they try and chain stun and kill you. That's gonna save you a lot. Okay. Fighting up against Darkseer. No way to kill him, though. Tide has the Ravage, but no point for the,
Old 11. Able to get that Dark Pack off, as well as escape with the Shadowed Hands.
Just running into a fog. I will be right back, Toby.
You're doing your thing now?
Yeah, I saw Vilat just did it, so I'm like, yeah, maybe I can get out and...
I'm gonna tag team after, maybe I can find a nice connection too, because it's still a bit jumpy.
Tell me if you find one.
You tell me as well. I'll take yours. Okay, so... everything just starts to settle down a little bit more on the lanes. Like, old 11's fine with this, like, he takes a little bit of damage, then he just heals back up. Latam, however, oh, okay, he actually gets it done, but the Gush already hit him. The slow is pretty brutal. The support is there, it's Ice moving over. Doesn't get there in time.
Yeah, and he doesn't have the mech yet either, so he can't really bail out here. And that's gonna put Tidehunter at enough money to get his Arcane Boots and important levels for Bounty Hunter, as we were talking about.
This is the most amount of infused raindrops I've seen picked up.
Oh, they're so good, dude.
You got them on Tidehunter and you got them on Slark.
Yeah.
So both the offlaners are running this.
Yeah, I mean, it really saves you against some chain stunts. And the passive of them is pretty good as well. Mana region. Oh, I'm looking at CS though. We're 9 minutes and 30 seconds in. Sven has 78 CS. This is the perfect CS record. It kills 4 more creeps. In 10 minutes, or in the next 30 seconds, that's a perfect CS.
It's a shame they're not all lane creeps, though.
Yeah,
like,
I mean,
a lot of them are jungle ones, but he's got the 3 kills also to his name with
no
deaths.
Name, so I think we can fairly say that this van has more gold than a completely free-farmed left attendant.
Yeah,
hero. Now clearing up a stack as well with the centaurs and the wolves. Tons of gold. And Lina being given the space here to solo up after a lot of experience.
That counts as very off from old 11. I want to wait until this rotation's happened from, oh, okay.
Yeah, you wait.
I thought Lanham was going to jump in from behind. That's not to be the case. He still doesn't have his level 6 yet. When the Finger of Death is up, then this kill potential of EHOME becomes a lot better.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, they truly need the Lion's levels. In general, they just need to play around the DK, though.
My turn.
Go. The Tidehunter on bottom lane gets caught out by Earth Spirit. Ravage being used though, running away, and he will all the search.
Oh, he got Finger of Death.
Oh, that was funny. It looked like he animation canceled it, but it was just, you know.
It's just the lag.
It's just. We couldn't see it on that frame.
Well, at least I didn't miss the kill, just missed the ending of it.
And that does mean that Ravage was used and he still died. That's nothing you want to have happen to you as a Tide.
Mm hmm.
Really sad day.
I'm going to try again. Bottom tower is under attack.
Dire's structures are fortified. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is
It's just like tower trading.
Yeah, it really is. Both teams are pushing. I mean, Darkseer is pursuing the Tide, but he could really kill a Tidehunter on his own, so... we'll see if the Slark can go for anything here. I don't even think he should try for a deny. Risking dying if he messes up.
Checking our bottom lane, the smoke maneuver.
They've seen the stack now. That's a pretty big thing. They know there's a lot of creeps.
They're actually blocking it out with the sentry ward next time around.
Yep.
Now they want to kill off the Tidehunter. But the Dragon Knight, well, they pop into dragon form. They bolt it's over. Spider XZ, because he's got, obviously, no Ravage.
Yeah, meanwhile, so, as well, they're trying to old Evan. He gets the Dark Knight off Beautiful Clue. Thanks, I'm so Radiant's top
tower is under attack. Literally in the ears. Got attacked and went down at exactly the same time because the announcer. Defender is ready to fight. He's actually got his level 6 now, so Magnetize is on the field.
Yeah, that's a massive ulti. It really is dangerous when he has enough stones for it as well. Pursue a big fight. Magnetize, his ulti is about to run out.
Caught out. So the Earth Spirit of Boulder and Kick was able to reach him.
A little bit too greedy this time, Demon, sticking around as everyone else backed out. Gets punished for it. That is a big kill to give away as well. Not that he feeds a lot of gold on his own, but this Slark is really... he's really hungry, dude. He has not been farming enough creeps, so when he sees a hero, go for it.
Hello, Sven.
Yeah, he's going for the standard Echo Saber after Helm of Dominator. the most common builds that we see nowadays, and then Blink Dagger afterwards, and then BKB.
I'm interested to see what Inflame wants to build into. It's like, normally with a Bounty Hunter, you can get him into a utility thing if he just level 6 up in time.
Sure.
It actually looks like, because this could be a casual buckler over on the Tidehunter,
yeah,
or it could be the full
mech. They're going drums on the Razor and mech on Tides.
Okay.
And fight around that.
It's because the Razor was holding on to like 1.1k gold. I was like, that was where my mind was like a lead to.
Yeah.
Like, what exactly is he going to do with it? All. But this helps your cause.
Ancient.
Well, they both take it. You ask the question, who gets it? They both
who gets
take it.
They're like brothers. That's what they do. Tide got a little bit. I feel he's the little brother in this trade, though.
Inflames down. Finger of Death does its work. A quick pick and no buyback.
Yeah, massive kill to get as well. The Razor being too aggressive there while his team was farming the Ancients.
And you still take out the tier 1 tower. Now 400 gold away from having that Shadowblade over on the Slark. And the mid tower is going to drop as well, so you may as well say you're 200 gold away. Ulchig is going to get stunned up there by demons, but with a creep wave and the catapult behind it, you could fortify all you want here. The chance of a denial of the tower is almost next to nothing. The tower, and it's killed by the Dragon Knight. Ravage or not, that Darkseer back wall causes real issues. And Amy's still trapped inside of it with the Darkseer Illusions attacking in. Now in comes Fenrir. Turn on the Magnetites, move to the tree lines. The Bounty Hunter gets kicked into oblivion.
And only Bounty Hunter gonna be the one to fall though. And that is still a clean tower, no deny. And they also got the top tower just before, so.
Yep.
A lot of momentum here for EHOME right now.
And with the Shadowblade done over on the Slark,
he can start being effective.
Do you actually go directly into Silver Edge, considering that's some really cool stuff to rake in this game?
It's a very cost-effective item, 15 to all, just like that, and then you also get the Silver Edge upgrade. You know, it's just a great upgrade in general, even if there's nothing super important, like a Bristle back or anything. It's just a strong thing to have lower cooldown, mainly. And if you hit someone like Tidehunter right before he ravages, that's a weak ravage. Always something.
Oh. Poor Adam. The sentry's down, so they know the Bounty Hunter is here. At the same time, the Orbs and the sentry have been placed by the Dire side, both out of range of each other, so both teams will keep their vision inside the Dire jungle, but old Lanham as well as Ice.
The tractor. They're trying to have the Warcry movement speed as well available. They're trying to pop drums and just chase this. They really want Lanham.
That's a long way to go, and the Tide's gonna die in the meantime.
Wow.
Lanham will turn for the stun. He's obviously gonna go down, but yeah, that Tide's dead underneath the tower, and he floats Ravage.
Dead. So that's the second time he uses Ravage to try and save himself, but did not mesh do so. That is not a very good day for XZ.
That's gonna give so much more confidence now for EHOME to go for more and more kills. Like Sven gets initiated on now in mid lane.
Sure.
Ice trying to body block him up for a bit. Sven goes for the Storm Bolt. He's already used his Warcry. Ghostbreak's on cooldown, so doesn't have that to work with either. But with the large amount of support coming in, they think he can survive, but with the stun, the Breeze Fire as well, so Sven will die. Ice retreats himself out through the mid lane. And with the help of the Earth Spirit with the Magnetize, it's causing real problems. Demons is dying in the tree lines. Victoria's not that healthy either. This can be a double kill for Fenrir, making a triple kill for him.
Jesus.
And nothing is lost for EHOME. They're now 10-6 on the board.
They're trying to TP in and react to this and take the fight, but after you bend your Ravage, you really have nothing. Your bluff has been called. You have been seen using this skill.
Inflame. All 11 just slipped in through the rear. You can say goodbye to the Razor.
EHOME, they're getting the momentum here. CDEC are starting to crumble. They had a great early game, but losing a lot now. Tower, it will fall here.
Okay, you know how I thought that CDEC were in a great position after that 3-0 fight up on top lane?
Oh, they were.
It's gone. That feeling is gone. Not even just gone, it slipped away to the point where I have actually decided to burn it in a bin.
It's looking pretty dark. They did deward the Ancients and start stacking them again, but they're in a point now where if Dragonite wants to go there with level 2 ulti, maybe you could steal it. Yeah.
Well,
that's... We have seen some awkward wards going down in the between the winner bracket finals and the game. That's funny.
A way to get warded by the stack. Okay, I want to try this again. After this fight, I'm on 11. But he's still got like Dark Pact, he's got his Shadow Dance, he's got his Shadow Blade. I don't know how CDEC are meant to like properly initiate onto him.
Because
you can't use Ravage, and the Lina's Blindstrike Array like also takes time, which you could like trigger Dark Pact with.
Mm-hmm.
So Where's your initiate? Like, they don't have something like Lime, which is that quick jump in to control.
No, no, they don't have good heroes to go on a Snark at all. In fact, I was surprised that he died.
Dire's top tower is under
ability
attack
and has BKB available, so this is looking very hard to get a kill on. Walk through a sentry though, stun flies out, BKB used.
It negates most of it. I don't even hear spell damage right now in the game.
Well, they do track him up and try to move after.
That stun keeps that hunter away.
Wow, that stun was two screens long on my screen.
And in the meantime, old 11's ready to attack bottom lane, finding in flame. Leeches him up. You can start taking away the damage. When Fenrir arrives, you're still going to have enough. The double TPs will also arrive. And the Slug doesn't really have enough damage to help him out. So Fenrir might sacrifice himself for the kill. In fact, yeah, with the movement, they will. That's a track kill as well, so maybe it's
unstoppable as well. Fenrir was on a big killing streak here.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's been getting a lot of the last hits, and he's played really well. So.
But he's 6-for-2 now, so yeah. How's the Slark looking? Like, the Slark has managed to pick up, he's actually 2-2-2 across the board.
Yeah, he's got the Echo Saber now as well. I wouldn't be surprised to see him going into the Silver Sedge after. He's going for Demons? Chasing. Oh, he's going.
Demon's gonna miss the stun. Old 11, the Ravage is there. Yep. He doesn't have a way out of this. Like, Shadowblade was still on cooldown.
Well, if you Shadowblade in and then you use Dark Pact and Titan just standing next to you, then he's gonna go like, okay, so now you have no trick. L is ulti.
I suppose it does create space in a different lane. The fact that tier 2 tower now
that's
gets to go down.
Worst space creation ever.
I'm not saying it was great. Saying it's what happened.
Yep, that is true. He was next level. Clark, trying to work. A lot of smoke will be popped, but the only one there from CDC is Sven. He does farm them up fast enough and he's gonna run away. I do think he makes his way out. It's kind of hard to tell. I'm gonna go for a reconnect, I believe, as well. Toby, keep it floating.
Hey, I came in and it was already like lagging like hell. I would like to actually find out why we can have like perfect games and other times like insanely crap games.
Yeah.
If we can get an answer to that issue,
oh,
maybe
I
we
love
can
that
stop
Dragonite
this
shot. Go click on Dragonite again.
What's on the DK?
It looks.
Oh bad. Wait! Whoa! Hey! Hey there! Woo!
My DK looks normal. It's just yours as well.
I want to keep it looking like that. He holds the shield of power. Thank you, Perfect World.
Yeah. I like how he's just holding some shiny orb in his hand.
Yep. You know what he reminds me of? It's like those shield warriors. I always say he's Batman with the cutlass, but.
Alright, right.
But he could be close to it.
Something. Lanham, super aggressive here. Very deep in. Track comes in.
It's like he was waiting for that kick to arrive from Fenrir, but it came, but it never really hit properly.
Well,
the
he's got a kick to something.
The mech will give him a little bit of time. They don't have the Slark in this fight, so it's another track kill going with four heroes around from CDEC Youth. EHOME have to stop giving away these easy kills to CDEC because they're going to lose this big gold advantage that they gained.
EHOME are playing a little bit
sloppy.
You know, yeah, very spread out. They're not really cohesive as a unit all times. And Bounty Hunter trying to scout here. Very careful not to move into the ward vision. Good play. He does ward next to the sentry, but the sentry does die. Fine.
I really don't want to give up on finding a good connection to this server.
Yeah, same. But right now, I do think
we have to watch
engagements.
A lot of stuff brewing down here on bot lane. For the first time in a while, EHOME are actually grouped up as five.
And here comes Razor.
Oh, the sentry. They saw him. Spark worked it out because he lost his ultimate. We understood that he was visible for a moment, and now he's visible again. Things out again. The fact that they've got like vision around here.
Yeah, he's like, there's very, very aggressive wards down here, guys.
Well, HY is now the current coach of EHOME because everyone's staying in the trees.
Mm-hmm.
They get the track over on Slyke 2. He'll dark pack that off. They try and deward, at least with the sentry, take out the ult, but old 11. Can he get himself out of this one? No, he can't. He'll go down quickly. But it looks like a good back wall to go in combination, but where's your extra damage? It was there from Fenrir.
Are they getting away with it? Yeah. Dragon Knight is chasing, Rats comes in, he's on though.
That's really it. Ravage, Shiro was the only one hit by because the BKB is up and Fenrir gets back up to the tower. Amy drops low, through the green line, the creeper attack came too, but the DK is awarded the kill, and it's EHOME mopping up the pieces here of CDEC as they try and retreat back out again. XD goes down south, almost pulling the rest of EHOME away, and he's going to TP out the tree line. They don't realize where he is, Breeze has to fall down, but it's too late.
So in the end, it's a sad day to be the carry. Two carries. Sim is gonna stop a little bit. And he did go for the BKB before Blink Dagger. Interesting choice. Thought he might go for the Blink just to find the pickoffs, you know, set for his team even more.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Nah, he'll be a little bit short, and everyone is just very content farming up now. The Slark is working on his BKB, not actually upgrading for a Silver's Edge. I think this is a massive mistake, by the way. Lower cooldown, great stats, one of the most cost-effective upgrades.
Yeah.
Sure, BKB is good here, but I think Silver's Edge is great.
Well, here comes old 11 on bottom lane, and again, these entries are nicely prepared for CDEC.Y. They see what's happening. What the hell? How does a restart of Dota change that setting? You restart Dota and my camera speed just goes to max.
Well, I was saying that you were a little bit too slow. Catch up, Toby.
Dota, please.
It's messing with you at this point. Sven is going to get enough gold now, finally, after top wave. Have his Blink Dagger, and this could be bad news for EHOME as they're trying to push bottom.
Mm-hmm.
If he TP's down here, he could really look to punish.
Well, for now, I keep seeing this happen with old 11. He walks away. They're almost like they're almost playing this Slark like Spectre.
Yeah.
You have like the four guys grouped up, and then you're waiting for the Spectral Haunt to come in, so he's part of it. But it doesn't really happen that way. Old 11 comes in and then just fights at the end. I think I understand why he's doing it, because he wants the BKB cash at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
But it kind of leaves his team in a perilous position because they keep grouping up like they want to fight, but they don't have everyone ready.
Yeah, when I hear you saying they're playing it like Spectre, I get really sad because old 11, you know, I just think about how great his Spectre actually is, and I look to what he has, you know, achieved in this Slark game so far. He's really having a struggle game, so see if he can manage to recover. He is still looking pretty good for farm though. Roshan being attempted here by CDEC.Youth.
Ooh, they, with the God Strength, they do have a decent amount of damage, but it's like one of the very rare times to see Roshan being done without any form of negative armor.
Yeah, I mean, they didn't even use the Svenston to proc the Lincolns of Roshan, and then Gush. He actually just used Gush straight up, and it's not working.
Yep. But they're still gonna get it. EHOME won't get there in time. They start their TPs now, but they don't read the play perfectly. And the ults and sentries, which are down, CDEC, like, both teams can see that they're, like, there's mass warding there. The CDEC got what they came for.
I'm surprised CDEC don't just run out there and kill those wards. It's quite valuable. Even though you just did take Roshan, so in a way you could say, well, that ward doesn't matter, because next time Roshan is up, the ward's gonna be down anyway.
Hey, Ty could do it, he just comes in with a Quelling Blade.
Exactly. It wouldn't be a big effort. I don't know. Weird kind of play.
Yeah,
but speaking of Tide, Tide has a Blink, Sven has a Blink, Lean has a Yule Scepter. I think CDC are really ready to fight here. Maybe they're just waiting for one more mistake from EHOME. They have been spreading out a lot.
The EHOME are also finding their strength as well. Armlet, DK, being his mate on that creep.
Zoldasorb on the Darkster. Oh god, that's a big hiccup. And we have to remember, this is exactly an ice as ice type of item. Big place with this.
Oh, Victoria sees all.
Victoria, the Stalker. Chase after a lion here. Maybe breaking a TP scroll? No, not gonna go for it. A little bit dangerous, would probably die immediately if we're doing so.
Alright, the animation! It's like, gonna break TP scroll, hero disappears. 3 seconds more animation ends. Bottom lane, Earth Spirit, and up towards the air. He's still got his boulder of Belm. Okay, no, he doesn't.
Yeah. He does not have much available anymore as Demons can't claim that kill. And that's what CDEC were waiting for. Just uncharacteristic, or maybe in this game, characteristic takes from EHOME. They are spreading out a little bit too thin, I think.
It's a little odd.
Yeah. They're getting killed off. And where CDEC can really do this, though, because they have, like, Racer is so hard to kill. Yes, he did die once when they took Roshan earlier, but the other deaths have been during teamfights. I don't know. Feels like CDEC are clawing their way control of this game. Would they just... They just need to take a tower.
Old 11 of Victoria.
Oh, they're chasing.
Oh, they don't know. No. They have Ravage of Val, it's not even required. Animal comes up a double stun. Oh, it's low enough for him to get like a trade-off snipe with the Finger of Death. And, well, another expert. The anchor from Titan will finish the job.
Lanham has not had an easy game, and he was so close to his Link Dagger. I guess 1800 gold after dying. Poor him. Has to hurt.
He'll get there eventually.
He will, but it. You know, now he has to respawn and try to farm somewhere. He can't even
nice pick. Yules him up and towards the air, dropping down for Henry of the Stun Collar. It looks like Elias Wrecked Array and Storm Bolt, will be my assumption.
Alright. It looks like he died to that. Bounty Hunter will get last hit, and I'm gonna be right back, Toby.
Beautiful. So he got the last hit, but while all that's going on, like, this is CDEC.Y, they're playing very similar to what we saw, even the series that they lost. It was still like always smoke, maneuver, try to find a kill, and just keep like almost five-man training this down.
Sure.
It's good to a point, sometimes you also create a lot of space for the other cores to do work. You look at the top west right now, the tide is a long way back here, and four, like, three out of the top four still belong to the Radiant side.
Yeah, that's true. They are farming a ton on the DK and the Darkseer, especially when the Stark is playing aggressively and creating space. And now that he has a BKB, he might, you know, even be a little bit safe to create space.
Tori's gonna find him. That's your first stun. Have they got enough? You're gonna blow Ravish to ensure.
Scratch that, he's not safe.
Yeah. They actually have enough chain stuns to take care of him.
Yeah, they did have Ravage, but it's still fine. I mean, it's a track kill on a core. That's massive. Especially on the biggest farm of the enemy. And, well, they push down mid lane. Then working towards the crit now as well, so when this Aegis is gone, he's probably gonna add up, you know, some extra damage.
Well, Aegis is gone in 1 minute, so can CDEC really pull anything off within that minute when Ravage is down?
I think so. They're strong enough that they can take fights, especially with the Stark being dead now. I think they could have pursued even more aggressively there, but they did run on the reward, so... I guess it's a good play to back off. Meanwhile, EHOME actually kind of staying their ground here, sitting together. And we have Lanham picking up his
They want, I think they want to try and get a pick on the Bounty Hunter, that's why the Sentry Ward's in the lane. The issue is Victoria slips in behind them, and gives CDEC.Y all the vision they really require.
Yeah, he's so slippery. Sneaking through these wards like no prob, and now got a 4-staff as well.
You could say Victoria's a secret.
Hmm, hard to find. Toby going for low-hanging fruits. Fine. I approve that.
We're even low-hanging fruits. It's the fruit that it's not even fruit, it's
in your head.
It's what grows in the ground, man, it's corn.
Well. Alright.
Oh, that's nice. Lanham's actually in. They got the Tinker Hill ward.
Yeah?
They see Lanham just sitting in the tree line. He'll blink over even further, but now he's even deeper underneath the ward.
Lanham. Like this.
You can't work that, like, you can't predict that would be happening.
No, I mean, just give credit. That was a good word, and it's another turn. Lanham is having a terrible day here. 1-6 on his lion. I mean, Lanham is no for EHOME to make big plays. He definitely does deliver.
It's my turn. Yeah,
well,
we,
I think
we
got, ice, he's trying
we got,
to get a better connection
we got
as well.
The perfect connection into the game.
Yep.
And
that's fine.
I don't know if we're really going to have it this time around.
I think Ice just disconnected due to solidarity. Ice and Toby, they go way back.
We do, actually. I've known Ice for a very long time.
Yeah, it's cool.
Oh, I knew Ice back in 2006, I think it was.
Yeah.
When I met up with Ice. Holy crap. Yeah, 2006.
Almost as old as you.
I wouldn't say that. He's old.
That's evil.
He's not that old.
Alright then. Well, I just want to highlight in this game, the game has been going, you know, EHOME feeding kind of a lot of kills right there and, you know, left, right, and center. But Dragon Knight and Darkseer, neither of them have died a single time in the game. They are keeping up decently in farm, sure throwing behind the Sven,
yeah,
but...
It's a Sven. Like, yeah. They're never going to keep up with him.
Exactly, it's a Sven. But if you get a farmed enough Dragon Knight, he can actually frontline pretty well against Sven. Mm-hmm. If you get level 16 up, you know, just need half of this.
I kind of also want to see what happens when he does get that level 16, when you start adding the slow to,
ooh,
like, the big AoE combination. Yeah, this Sven is fat as crap.
I love this, the Envy Shivas on Inflame. Wonderful. Actually,
that one.
I'm not sure that it was Envy that started. He was just the one that, you know, popularized it in the Western scene. I think he could have even taken it from the Chinese players. So this is going to be really hard to DPS into, especially for Stark. Lowering that attack speed so much.
Smoke maneuver. CDEC.Y, they're on their way in. And there's your blink stun from the Sven. Be ready for your Raven. It's gonna pop
boy
on out. They keep all chicken. In fact, they just explode all chicken. Move on to Ice. Low sword will trigger up. But okay, flyback from DK. They really want to get a revenge kill for this one. They have to make this flyback worth it. Darkseer back into a two-man wall. You do have your
the
finger against the pound this Sven. But you're in first for the front lines. BK can achieve it. Aura up 270 stones. Point damage. All of them drift. Find this for BK. He will wear it, but a lot of it has to bounce himself away. Almost time for that last pack. In fact, he does. Will he? Victoria can't reach him.
Oh, Jesus. This is so close. Racer is going to TP out safely. They're still looking for something here. Snark going in. Dragon has to blink behind as well.
Well, it's the upside. They have the Gem of True Sight, so Bounty Hunter can't just hide inside of that invis. Old 11 is exactly where he is. He needs to hit that pounce properly, but... Victoria, eluding for a bit. Now they're going to find the Lina. Not enough damage.
She's gone?
Yeah, she's gone.
Yeah.
Let me just get confirmation from... Yeah. Yeah, she's gone. She's
from
gone.
The headquarters in the Dire Base. We have reports.
Tango has escaped.
It's, you know, sometimes you need to double check these things. Hi back from the Dragon Knight. He didn't get too much done with it. The Racer definitely showed his presence with the Shiva's BKB. They can't do anything to him. During the time that his BKB on then, they just need to wait out the fight, and he got to kill two heroes during that. Looks now like EHOME want to smoke up. Do have the Finger of Death ready in a while as well. I'm gonna have it for this fight.
Yeah, and shell up the DK as well. Where this would have been so far.
It looks crisp.
Crisp. It's crisp, bro. It's crisp. Oh, here they come. The jump forward. Blind. Start with the Hex over on Sven. They get the stuns going right now. The BKB's up from Inflame. Finger of Death is hitting heavily onto the Sven, but they're going to get that damage out. Oh, Chicken, he's trying to do it. And they do bring down the Sven finally. Inflame's BKB will wear off an old 11 with that 23 points of stolen attributes. He's just going to rip apart the secondary core. The big fight from EHOME.
Oh,
and they're on the doorstep of CDEC.Y. Catapults to two. Victoria. Port pushes off away, but the Chicken's there to back it up. They'll buy back on the Razor, the big Raven, catching three, Refresher, we go bouncy again, two of them down, Yul's over from the, he's still got 24 points, and the ability to pick up away to safety, maybe fight again, but nope, they retreat out.
Has to run away, secure the gem, make sure not to lose more, and in the end, EHOME, only losing one hero there as well. Sure, this is his dieback, so he's dead for long now on the Dragon Knight, but that was massive, forcing out a buyback again, teams really going heavy at each other.
That is the reason why we kept DCing and reseeing. It was beautiful to watch that fight in all frames.
I was watching it on screen.
Yeah. The world was terrific engagement. And that easy because they have such a that you can swing of almost, it was like 18,000 gold. Experience was almost roughly the same.
Yeah, it was a big deficit that they then recovered.
And now the bigger items also start to arrive. Like, Old 11 gets tankier, he's able to pick up Guardi. The fact Old 11 also started that fight with so much Essence Shift, like, CDEC.Y, they willingly fought into a Sucker who was already buffed up. And like, it's not as, like, I say, if it's kind of the same thing as, like, we looked at the OD. Like, he wants to steal so much intelligence. Well, now, oh, what a scary time! They see him go invis and walk up, and ba-boom! Bounty will drop! And Ice looks for the fight, and he actually goes to the cliff in flame. The TP out, the wall will happen. Do they have an extra stunner kick? There was nothing available. The rest of CDEC are bailing out, and in flame only TP'd out to the tier tower, so he's still in the neighborhood for the fight.
Yeah, Ice, he would go for those cheeky plays. Too bad they didn't have a disable close enough, or the Razor could have been in an awkward position. But they're gonna back out for now. They're waiting for the Finger of Death to be ready as well. Ravage is down. Yeah, does have the refresher available in 80 seconds again as well. I wasn't sure if it was my screen lagging or if it was actually two Ravages there, but...
I called it out in the middle of the fight, bro. That was a fresh refresher for that fight.
Fresh?
Yeah. Hey, you see what I did there?
Very fresh.
But it does make CDECs now, like, their initiation... Like, you'd always be a little bit concerned that you'll only hit, like, one target with your first jump in, but because they don't have someone like a Lion, the Ravage, even with the Refresher, you're almost happy for that to happen. Like, yeah. As long as you get the initial jump to find the first kill, then everyone else comes in, then you Refresher and you blow again.
Exactly. It was also that surprise factor, because they hadn't really seen that he had it before, and then all that...
Here's 11! And you can say goodbye to Victoria! I'm sorry, she got eliminated from China's next portal.
Yeah, Bounty Hunter, not gonna win this one, sorry. Wearing a mask doesn't help.
I don't know. Oh, okay. He's not even really intending this. He gets the four-man kick onto the high ground.
He knows. Huh? He knows what he's doing.
He's actually in the perfect position if CDEC want to try this. On 11 will jump in this. They got a sentry ward down it, but they don't... they don't have the orbs to couple with it, just 11th rotation. And with them moving back to CDEC, while they go straight past EHOME and allow the tier tower just to get pushed out of the bot lane.
Yeah, but CDEC don't really get anything. Sure, they're just running around here. EHOME taking some on them.
Are we back? Look at this graph. Reach highest, there ain't no mountain high enough. Yeah. Ain't no valley low enough to keep me zeroing this out.
And then there's farm going in top and mid as well for them. So yeah, I think EHOME are about to break this dead even. And oh, they're dewarding so much with the gem as well. It's going to be hard for CDEC to play out from this. They do get a nice deward of their own though, by the looks of things. And they have a gem as well. Both teams can play for that. They have a smoke ready on Lina. If they push out, maybe they will try.
Picky bet now, like EHOME going up high ground. Like, I know the team fights could be the next critical part, but with that Aghanim scepter, like, approaching for a Tidehunter.
Oh yeah. It's great for defending high ground.
Yeah, and you got Dragon Slave, you got Plasma Field, you got Stormball Cleave. Yep. So you can't even really get like a big momentum of a wave up. The only way EHOME really wins this game is by either winning a fight getting CDC. Roshan and getting an Aegis Immortal onto the DK. But all chicken already there. The sentry's there. They want to kill the bounty on nice and quick. There goes your first ravage. The BKB up on chicken. The back wall finds that side. Catching a three. The BKB's going to go to work as Inflame starts dealing a huge amount of damage on the back lines. However, all the left trying to balance until he pounces back out again. The double stun from Lanham. The ravage will see this. He'll be there for XZ. We saw so many teammates on the left. Is he going to survive from this when he's so low? Oh, he runs away under the cover and he will come back this fight in just a bit. All chicken still surviving through this fight as well. It's a 2-for-1 trade-off.
EHOME just need to pursue, keep them there for a snark.
Oh, here comes the bowler. Fenrir's on the way. They slow down the Titan. You can anchor smash all you want. And there's Ice. He's ready to go again on 11. Pounces on top of Inflame. All that stolen damage does nothing. The TP out from Titan under. Is there a stun? No, there's not. The Dragon Tail and range form was almost there.
Was
but there's
close.
No Razor for 90 seconds now. They can take Roshan and potentially start chipping away at these tier 3s.
Yeah, I think you're gonna take Roshan and just start buying up items. They have 5k gold on Ice. So much money at their disposal. I'm not even sure what Ice wants to go here.
I'd assume like straight Scythe is where I would go.
Yeah, a Scythe would be really great. I think they could go for Sivas as well if they want to mitigate some of the physical damage output.
Yep.
He has many options, but We'll see what he does. And this guy has such good walls, he could even go Aghanim if he wants to. Like, he hits a lot of people with these backs.
It seems to me like they're willingly grouping up as well to allow ISIS to have these moments.
They are.
Like the moments they keep fighting, like this horrible choke point here. You walk up there, yep. it's a Darkseer's wet dream.
It really is. And I guess they don't have the best chain stun after the Earthspike, but they still have a good hefty combo. And stacking up, you just tank so much. The Breathe Fire, for example, denies so much damage from everyone on your team. Oh, that's an Aegis on Slark now. Old 11.
Here's your courier run. You nailed it, man.
Shivas it is.
All Shivas. And still enough. Well, okay, he'll have enough money to buy back with this next group wave. How's old 11 looking? I really wish he'd finish up his Silver Edge.
Well, yeah, he disassembled earlier for Scotty, but I agree. He could go back for it. Now, there is one point being made that he's so far now that he could just think about Shadow Blade eventually, and you know, maybe even skipping it into something like a Blade. It's better if, when you have a Soul Blade to go into that. So, he might get rid of that.
In a way, I can understand that, but also, like, it's a Slark, so using invisibility is like his bread and butter for that Shadow Dance.
Yeah, in a way. It's more reliable initiation to go with a Blink later on. Later a game goes, the more likely it's going to be that there are sentries everywhere.
Yeah.
I mean, we have seen some 95 sentries supports, right, in this tournament?
Mm-hmm.
When you hit that lightning.
Lotus Orb is now done over on the Bounty Hunter.
Mm-hmm.
So, even if it was a Scythe, like, that's not going to... Like, they got ways to dispel some of the control abilities already from EHOME.
I still think two Lotus Orbs should be infinite.
Oh, all 11 so close. He doesn't have the gem, however, over on the Slark. The gem is currently sitting over on the DK instead. Loop around the CDEC. The ward is up. They initiate over on Fenrir. The Ravage will pop, taking out more heroes. BKB up on 11. He'll initiate in, but he's already lost the line as well as the Earth Spirit, and the damage being removed from him. He'll have to outrun him. The pounce is now back off cooldown with a Shadow Dance. Just keep running. Pop the little legs. And EHOME, you see what they do.
Look at that.
It's like, okay,
gaggle.
You lost your two supports, and you just force out the side lanes. You get the EC to go into damage control while your supports are down.
Yeah, and that's pretty fine for EHOME. They actually did really good damage control just getting out with everyone there.
The fact there was no second chance for the Ravage. Titanta did use the Refresher Orb, but he didn't blow the secondary Ravage.
Yeah, you could always do that as well if you play Titan. As soon as you Ravage once, just refresh immediately. Sure, it's a little bit longer. It's 45 seconds longer cooldown than the Ravage itself. But this way, you never get into those awkward scenarios where you have 30 seconds until Ravage and you have Refresher ready.
Yeah.
Never want to have that happen if you go into a team fight. So, this way, it just prevents that.
That's a very good point.
And, looking like CDC, they're definitely clawing and protecting their part of the map, and they have some terrible, terrible damage in this Sven. Whenever they initiate it, just people die immediately. Unless, of course, it's the DK popping his BKB immediately. He was fast.
Is this an EHOME group up for smoke? I got gems, smoke? Yep, there's a smoke over on the Earth Spirit at the moment. You gonna do your thing?
Gonna watch up your screen while I reconnect this computer?
Luckily, I hear I'm a good observer.
One of the best. It's fine. I mean, it's not like I have other observers here competing with you. In this studio.
I was about to say, well, depending on how big you look at the studio being.
Yeah.
Right. CDEC.Y, like, they got no other choice but to hide inside their base. There's still no double Ravage for 80 seconds. Top lane pushes in, but EHOME really don't have the greatest way to force the high ground. Like, maybe if that Assault Cuirass was done on the DK, which it actually almost is. He's only 200 gold away from finishing it.
Yeah, he's looking so farmed.
And the Monk King Bar, the Rock, the Slock, so... And
some of them are saving buyback, but... Stand dark. Aegis. I can't actually see that.
The Aegis goes down in 1 minute. I got 1 minute left in the Aegis. So I'm wanting to know, like, what he dropped for the MKB.
True. Well, I guess he could...
Okay.
I think you dropped the Echo Saber right now for it.
Ice is next item build.
Octarine?
No Scythe, yeah, it's gonna be Octarine.
Yeah, that makes sense actually. Lower cooldown for the vacuum. fine. Actually, lower cooldown for everything is going to be really good, because Shiva's, Lotus Orb, Blink, everything just makes a lot of value. I mean, Octarine gets better the more items you have that also benefit from it, not just your hero.
This movement from CDEC.Y, from EHOME, like the fact that Curry's still holding back here with the Monkey King bot, it's like they want to say, you know, we're not going to force anything under this point of the Aegis the Immortal. Actually, I don't think they can anyway.
No, I mean, they're playing very safe on CDC, so... So I think it's fair. None of the team's really looking for a fight right now.
This Razor. I'm wondering, like, if he says on the barrel of finishing up his Butterfly or not. And is Butterfly really the item to go, like...
Well, MKB is already coming up, so we know that he's going to be a little bit unfortunate.
Yeah.
It adds a lot of damage for him, it does. Attack speed is good.
Maybe it's worthwhile then, like, just slipping into, like, a Halberd.
Yeah, I mean, there's some different options for him. You could even go into the Axe Refresher, actually. Just have double BKB, double ulti.
Oh, Inflame! Don't walk up the hell! The Suns will be there! The Lotus Orb is on trap protection to release the rest of the burst damage. Triggers the BKB now, as the Sven also wants to fight these BKB timing, however, are being expended so far. Now the Ravage hits him on 11. He's still in the Shadow Dance. The secondary stun on 11. Is he going to drop the stun there from Latham? He makes the space of Finger of Death on the Luka Blink. They go out. Yes, he is escaping to regen to fight another day. Oh, Chicken is the one who's forced this hand hero fight up against CDEC. And maybe with damage from the Magnetize, they could get a revenge kill. Amy's retreating back. Is that damage actually enough?
Oh,
he's
sticking
out inside the base. With 36 HP, he will survive. You gotta run further west as Victoria is running away from the gem-carrying lion.
Oh,
he picked
dead.
It up from the DK's cold dead fingers. Drain the mana, get the kill. The Slark back into the fight.
What a back and forth fight. If that Slark died, that would have been a disaster right there, but they actually managed to prevail really nicely. Lanham having some big plays there. He missed one stun kind of awkwardly, but rest was really well executed. CDC. I love the Ravage though. He timed it so well for the Slark today. Had a little bit more help, he could have brought him down. Double Ravage, holding him in place during ulti.
See, this is the duo I wanted to see in the first series between
Exactly. This
between
is what
CDC
we...
and Noobie, but now CDC are finally like, they're clicking, their length of... Their team fight execution's getting better, and EHOME stepping up to the plate as well.
Yeah, this is what we're expecting from the finals, this China qualifier. Now, just playing a little bit careful is CDC. They know they really need these double ravages, so getting too far out. They know the Slark is out there waiting for them. Nah, I'm just looking towards the Slark and thinking when he's gonna change. His next item. He could keep the Silver's Edge or the Shadow Blade and go into the Epistle. I think that makes the most sense right now.
Mm-hmm.
Or you could, you know, get rid of the Shadow Blade, but I don't value the Echo Saber over Shadow Blade. I don't think so.
Yeah, it's not like over something more like the control locked out of an Abyssal Blade plus having the Silver Edge break.
Exactly. It's more a matter of which of those items you get rid of. The Abyssal Blade is definitely something you want. There are some other items you could go. I mean, he could even go Butterfly if he wants to. Because this Sven is never getting an MKB. Look at his items. I mean, he could maybe, but you don't want to build that. Sven has to get a Satanic, and he already went Daedalus, so he's kind of committed now.
That Axe is done over on the Tidehunter.
Yep. Got the full items. The high ground defending is a lot easier. You could take the more casual approach, not just dive in. And a lot of people are playing without buyback money on this.
Ooh, a smoke maneuver from EHOME. They've got the vision thanks to the observer wall that's there. The dewarding is happening, but it looks like EHOME, if they can get the initiation over and they can take the Tide Ravage out of this play, it may be a big thing for him. But they've jumped up instead. Victoria's at the Finger of Death. Lina just evaporates. Toria's still trapped outside. He's going to go for the 4-star TP out, which will be successful.
It's going to be fine, but that's still Lina dying, and this is where I worry for CDC. They're playing so many heroes without buyback. Racer, no buyback. Tide, no buyback. Lina, no buyback. And Bounty Hunter, same there. So, this is very, very risky. When you die this close to your base, you might get punished. They're going to go off EHOME here, respecting. Lina was not enough to prompt them to try high ground.
Well, for now they still do control the map, and they didn't have any Ravage pops. The double Ravage is still available from no Tidehunter, from the Tidehunter. So it's still insanely risky to go high ground against CDECY. I think that's the main reason why this game is going to keep dragging out. Until EHOME get more than just one support hero down, they can't aggressively attack into the high ground, which is why I kind of hope it is actually the Abyssal Blade Silver Edge out from the Slark. It's the is still having your initiation item, plus having your lockdown item to ensure like solo pickoffs. They just need to see where CDEC come out, get the pick, and then go for objective-based gaming. They have another 37 seconds for Roshan, and that looks to be like their next positional play.
Yeah, but Refresher and Ravage are both ready, so I think they should be looking to make a play for this Roshan. There's a smoke as well for CDEC. They're gonna go right now. After pushing this mid-wave, they should guaranteed smoke.
Oh, there she blows. Five up under the cover of smoke. They move down. There's old 11s on the front lines. He'll break the smoke. Town's available, but already the Ravage will connect. And old 11, oh wow, gets nuked so hard.
That's some hate, and they want to get the bounty for this. They want to get the Roche. Oh,
what a time. Okay, Slark, do you buy back?
Wow, that timing. You walk in and you're just like, yep, there he is.
There's no way EHOME... Okay, yeah, they know because the Gush also flew over the top of the Observer one. But EHOME is fully aware of what's going on. The kick gets off target. The refresh has already been used. Slark will buy back. Ice. No! He was too late! And now he gets hit by the Ravage! He tried to go for the Mega Play with a big backup onto the wall. Now Old Chicken, he's gonna go down. The help from Fenrir turning on the Magnetine. Ven locked inside the Roche Pit. Lion with a finger of death able to ensure that kill. Ven still not buying back just yet. He may have to in a moment if he wants to try and save his core in flame. The Yorsup keeps Fenrir out of the play. But now does he have a chance? The evasion is there thanks to Butterfly. But in comes the Slark right on top of the Razor. They're even going to lose Victoria. Latham's on the hunt. The stunt Well, he can blink into Yules and still hold Victoria there, but he'll just hold onto their abilities. They're going to finish the job.
All just set up. He's like, guys, I'm going to burst the Ravage. Just watch me. Just watch me, boys.
Well, they did burn through both Ravages, but it looks really bad.
That's true, but it was two Ravages to use for two people, and that's it. Then I have the Ravage for a big plus team fight, and that's where really the only thing looking like a Ravage was Lion blinking and stunning two people really, really quickly. And yeah, that Sven is dangerous, but if he doesn't have lockdown for him, he can actually right-click people. It's bad.
EHOME really need to force some damage into the tower. But Sven and Razor both have buybacks, and you still have to remember that they expended the buyback over on the slot. So you need CDEC to have some level of disadvantage as far as the defense goes, and that's where the buybacks come into play. On 11 with the Aegis Immortal won't feel so sad about buying back because obviously they got so much out of it.
Yeah.
Demons, Stun's not chicken, on 11, you're still fine, man. I guess you have a Moonshot as well inside of him, and he tries to beat through the racks.
His DPS is very high right now. He might just back up here with Dark Tax and HP regen.
Raises up in 8 seconds too, this is...
There's that spammy high ground defense, it's not gonna be easy to break.
But there's no Ravage.
There isn't, but it's hard to initiate still, because this is pretty deep.
Sentry's down. They definitely see old 11, especially now that he's tracked up.
That kick is so slow now. The EF kick, it's really hard to initiate with that alone. To be a lot faster.
Okay.
I don't think they go here. Yeah.
Didn't realize he actually, he bought BKB and still just walking around with a casual soul booster. Always wondering if I think this game's gonna go on so long. He's like, you know what, Bloodstone's to play?
Well, no, I think he's going, oh!
Wow, the jump! They found Demons, remove a big part of the nuke. Finger of Death's gonna go to work, 2 and 20. Starts to deal a lot of damage, 126, but not as much as he had before, but the Ravage, it only, he does get old 11 as well. Adam.
Oh,
the Laguna Blade! From the buyback of Lena, killing off the gate, but Ben comes out to the fight. Fenrir turns on the magnetize. Now everyone just pulled to his allure. And well, 80 going to drop for Rizzy, the Shadow Blade Elemental. He got the vibe.
Fenrir gets away.
There's two men dropping. The buybacks are coming.
It's a never ending stream of buyback from CDC, but what does it actually accomplish? They're going out again.
They killed the DK. Demon. That's all they really got, but they're fighting. The back is there.
Oh,
the king! Perfect! It's a stun from Adam. His finger is back off cooldown. He's just popping over the target. The Ravage will blow him in the Yule Scepter. The Lion, he dodges the Ravage and then blinks himself away. The finger to ensure the kill over on the Razor. He is playing so beautifully. Another stun and the leash on Tidehunter. His 31S is currently shifted. The Razor's down for just under 2 minutes. Now EHOME can finally finish up the mid-rack.
EHOME with the place. They're just manhandling CDEC here. They can't do anything. They're trying to get a kill on ES. Everyone else bails him out. I mean, whatever they try here, it doesn't work.
It really doesn't. Man, Lanham has made so much space in just this fight, let alone the rest of the map. And they're looking to get even more. If he can blink and get the initiation on the Tidehunter, okay, that's not going to happen when he goes just like that. But old 11, still with Aegis the Immortal in the hands. That's the crazy thing.
And 93 stacks as well. I thought that fight might go well for them when they killed the cheese carrying Dragon Knights. Oh, they're going in here.
Yep.
Aggressive.
Their fingers back off cooldown. Look for the follow up stun. The fan dead so quickly. The Lotus Orb didn't come up in time in CDEC. They call the GG. EHOME will decay number one up against CDEC.Y. And this has been a day of nightmares for CDEC.Y. As now they have lost three straight games after 2-0 down by Newbie. Oh, it's a tilt. It's real. Like, you had such a big advantage in this game as well. The fact that you managed to claw it back, you pulled up that much in your favor, and then the straight spike, that big fight in mid lane.
That last fight was just...